As Spartan Davis continued fighting on the moon, Spartan Palmer and a handful of UNSC troops redeployed to the surface of Drathius V to fend off the invaders there.
Spartan Davis and Palmer weren't really getting along too well.
Outmanned? Outgunned? Spartan Palmer didn't see it as a problem.
Well, that's because Palmer is an idiot. I do see it as a problem. Because I'm smart. Hey there, everybody. Welcome back to Let's Lore here on Halo Canon. Today we'll be continuing with Operation B, whose name I've already forgotten. Should have written that down. Here we are with the first mission today, the Siege of Faraday, as it is called. Let's see. Although Spartan Palmer was successful in warding off and warning Drathius V of the coming attack, the Covenant assault hit the colony's defenses like a tidal wave. Drathius V main outpost, Faraday Base, which seems to be I can't help but wonder if that's a nod to Halo Reach in some form. Anyone remembers Faraday Base that you would go off and defend in the second level there, Oni Sword Base. And yeah, Faraday Base and some, I don't remember the other location, the battery. What is it? The weapon battery. Or whatever it was. We'll find out when we get to Halo Reach. Anyway. Faraday Base was located on the border of an expansive verge to the north of an eroded, whatever. Yeah, try reading a level description as you're playing. Not my best idea. But at least it gives me something to talk about. Like I said, we got Faraday Base. Oh my god, look at the size of those rocket launchers the Marines are carrying. Holy hell. One thing that fascinates me, and I'm sure it's fascinated other fans, at least since Halo 3 when they were first introduced, suicide grunts. In most mainstream Halo games, you just have, you know, some grunts will just decide, hey, our leader's dead, we're probably going to die, let's try and take somebody with us. But, you know, games like, you know, some of the, you know, basically not the non, for lack of a better term, main games. They actually have entire squads dedicated just to, committing suicide. And I don't know. I just can't help but wonder what exactly does the Covenant do, or what do the elites do? And it's right past that to convince these grunts, like, hey, why don't you go commit suicide, because that seems like a fun thing to do. Yeah. That's just one idea. I guess that's one thought that always crossed my mind about these guys. Go, go, go. There we go. And you die too. I was going to talk about, the Wolverines. Because I don't think I've talked about those enough just yet. Wolverines making a return in this game. Interesting little factoid. Back when Halo Wars was developed, I don't know if this is necessarily canon, because it was more, featured in an interview, never, at least as far as I know, never mentioned in any official canon source other than that, they're based. Oh my god, I just noticed that the bodies melt into the ground. How have I missed that up until now? Yep, let's get some ammo. What was I going to say? Oh yes, that, they came up with explanations as to why all this tech didn't appear in, Halo CE and whatnot. And for the Wolverines, at the very least, there was the explanation that the factory that that where these were manufactured on Mars was bombed by insurrectionists in 2535. So, again, I don't know if that's still necessarily official, you know, official canon material, or if that's, you know, since been decanonized, I suppose. I don't know. I don't know if there's a word for that. But, oh, yes. It'd be interesting to find out. Speaking of interesting things, this is the, I believe, the fourth time I have recorded this particular this particular Let's Lore. Why is that, you might ask? Right, simply because my computer is apparently being very stupid. I really don't know. I mean, oh, actually, the first time through, I had perfect audio. I had a perfect set of audio. I had, I had audio. I had a very nice, clean playthrough with almost no errors or nothing. I think I died once, but you know, I think I can allow myself to die at least once a Let's Lore. But then, like a genius, I deleted the video file because why the hell not? And then, of course, because I've never understood this about, you know, some programs decide if you delete something out of our program, it doesn't go to the recycle bin. It gets permanently deleted right on the spot. Oh, you want it? Oh, that was an accidental deletion? No, you can't have it back. That would make sense. That is very true. I deleted it. I tried my best to recover it, but I do not like programs that just decide we're going to permanently delete whatever you decide to delete from our program. So I was stupid. Is the easy answer there? Oh god, that elite just cannot. Anyway. There we go. Second mission complete. I think I only lost one Wolverine. Either that or that corpse was already there. Who knows? Anyway, on to mission B3, known as the Hunt for the Sangheili Commander. Well, Hunt for Sangheili Commander. Well, Commanders, I suppose. I don't know why they say Command. Oh, Sangheili Command. I misread that. Not so much a hunt as an absolute slaughter. No, come back! It's dishonorable to run. Don't you know that? You know, kind of like that. There we go. Keep your honor. Oh god, I hate some of the geometry in this. Alright, there we go. Oh, that was a fun accident. And that, kids, is why you shouldn't stand next to suicide grunts. I had something else. Oh, fun announcement today. You know, in some respects, the fact that it took me this long to record this might be a blessing in disguise. Because I do have, there is plenty of news to talk about. Such as today, there was an official announcement for some future Halo books. Nothing specific. Because, yay! There's my death for this Let's Lore. I get one per Let's Lore, I suppose. Stop throwing things at me. I'll hold off for now. There we go. So there was an announcement. 343's got a new publishing partner, it looks like. Gallery Books, I believe it was. I don't have the news story open in front of me, but hopefully either today or tomorrow I'll be able to make a an update about that. But we'll see how that goes along. Oh my god, what the hell happened there? But yeah. Grab one of those and book it out of there. And so they haven't really officially announced anything specific, like I said, but they did say that there would be a book coming out around fall of 2014. So assuming that Halo, you know, Halo Xbox One or Halo 5, whatever you want to call it, is still on track for this year, disregarding those quote-unquote other rumors. If you don't know what I mean, I'll probably talk about that too eventually. It could, you know, could be that we'll have a book lead-in for Halo 5, much like we did with Halo 4. Hopefully, not a terrible series of books like Kilo 5. And honestly, I hope, you know, if they don't do, they don't pull a Silentium again. Like I love Silentium. I've made that very clear. I like to think, but I feel that the book should have been released around the same time, if not before, Halo 4 was, because I gotta say it had a lot of what I would say was essential information for lore fans such as myself, that without it, Halo 4's story actually was significantly more confusing than I think it would have been it for someone who wasn't invested in the books. Because if you were, you know, you have this hero character, the Didact, all of a sudden being a bad guy. Whereas if you aren't invested in the books, you don't know the Didact, you just know that he's a bad guy. That's all you really needed to know as that, you know, as a non, you know, EU fan or whatever. But if Halo 5 is not releasing this year, the other big thing I'd want to see is Blue Team. I want to know what the hell they're up to, you know? What's Blue Team doing? What are the other Spartan 3s up to? And perhaps, you know, I think I briefly talked about it in my Reach timeline. Teams Gauntlet and Echo, or Red Gauntlet and Echo, these Spartan teams, not dissimilar from Noble, that were on Reach on August 23rd, helping with civilian evacuations. Boom, headshot. Because that's not overused. So there's a lot of potentially exciting topics to cover, but we'll see how that ultimately goes down. Oh my god, I think I'm gonna die again. I don't wanna die. Leave me alone. Oh god, no, leave me alone. I'm serious. Have an apple. Have an apple. Apples are delicious and deadly. An apple a day keeps the Covenant away. Not really, but you know what I mean. Alright, since every other time I run over the Marines, every other time I went the other way, I'll go up this way. Woo! Oh, this is actually a lot easier. But anyway, moving forward. Why did I just deploy a hologram? Alright. Die and die. But why ain't you dead? And hit. I don't know what I was gonna say there. yes. By the way, this level is called Battle for the Epsilon Expanse. Not exactly sure what that might mean, what that means. I don't think the level description really explains anything significant about that. Oh, it's a okay. There, it's the name of the gorge, I guess. I'm stupid. All right, here we are. Bad feet. I don't know. I fail. Okay. So, Battle at Red Slate is what this is called, as you might have seen. I'm pretty sure it says so. Okay, let's go. Let's start our thing. Get inside our fun little tanks. You know, easily the best part of the Spartan Assault are the vehicle sections. They're just so much fun. I will say, not the easiest to control. I mean, not hard. Get out of my way, ghost. Just very easy to get turned around. All right. Stay away from me! So, oh, they want to shoot a tank that I might need. I hope I won't, but you never know. And die, tanky. I think I just turned around and right into the plasma bolt. Oh, always fun. I don't know if they have yet included this, but I know it was in Halo CE. I don't think it's been in any Halo since. They gotta let you ride on the tank treads. Because that is so much fun in Halo CE. Actually, you know what? What I'd really like to see, now that I think about it, is like if you could exchange weapons with Marines that are on the tank treads. Because, you know, once they get on that thing, or when they get into a vehicle, like as a passenger or something, you cannot swap out their weapons, which can be very annoying. Especially since you can't actually get the, you can't proceed to get them off of those weapons, of the whatever it is. You know. Alright. Hey, the Mr. Ghost. How do you do? No, stay away. I don't want any chicken. I don't know why I chose chicken there. Little did humanity know that the Covenant did not want to kill them. It just wanted to steal their chicken recipes. For eons, the Covenant chicken had been cold and uncooked. But when they found humanity, they knew now their great journey would be over. That soon they would have cold, hot, they would have warm chicken that they could eat. Because everybody likes chicken. Okay, Mr. Tanks, where are you? Oh, God! Oh, God! I don't even know what that was. And now I have to do that all over again. I sad face. Go away, tank. Yeah, that's right. Get out of my way. Feel like I should have just let that one go. Wait. There we go. I gotta say, the only thing worse than driving this tank with a controller is driving it with a mouse and keyboard. Oh my god. So easy to get caught on corners and just die. Though admittedly, it is also significantly easier to aim with it in the mouse and keyboard. Because you actually have a reticule. Whereas here, I just have to guess the general direction and hope that the auto lock or the auto aim works. Oh, okay. Well, here we are on our mission to deny the Covenant our chicken A recipe for warm chicken. That's the best joke I could come up with. Without prompting. Or preparation, I suppose. Yeah. Gets in. It's like, oh, nope. Get out. Nope. Woo! Ah! No, Tank, I did not want you to turn. I wanted you to aim. There's a difference. You guys, stop it. Alright. Yeah. Speaking of Assault Ops, how about that extra credit achievement for anyone who had Spartan Assault on any other device before getting it on the Xbox, be it the 360 or the One? Which. You know, in one version I did talk about the fact that that Spartan Assault came out on the Xbox 360. Which, since I'm thinking about it and I desperately need something to talk about, let's talk about that. If you don't have it already, I would definitely... Spartan Assault is a game I would recommend getting. It's a lot of fun. It's worth the $15, which is, I'd say, pretty cheap. A pretty good price. Especially with the Flood Mode. The Flood Mode is just... I can't really geek enough about it. It is beautiful. Oh my god, my tanks are destroying me. Stop it. Oh god. The allied AI in here is worse than a main entry Halo game. Okay. Woo! Through Operation B, onto Operation C, Monolith. Next time, I guess I can't really make a promise about when and where. But yeah, so. Excuse me. I hope you're liking these Let's Lores. Any feedback you can give me is absolutely welcome. Positive, negative, what have you. Last thing before I go today, I was talking with a fan recently and they wanted me to do a Q&A. And you know what? I would absolutely love to do a Q&A if I could get enough questions. So, in the comment for this video and any videos within, I'd say, probably the next couple weeks, leave any questions regarding Halo canon or Halo lore that you have, or just Halo in general. I do focus more on Halo lore, but I don't mind talking about anything about other things just related to Halo in general. Leave me your message, leave me your questions, any you want, and when I feel I have a good amount, I'll do a Q&A video, and, hopefully that'll be fun. yeah. Well, this has been Halo Canon, and, My mind is going blank, I think. This has been Halo Canon, Let's Lore for Operation B and Spartan Assault. We'll see you next time, Spartans.